Sexual reproduction is that similar pattern in all living organism. They are having that so different structures, but they are sharing that similar pattern. So that is known as that sexual reproduction is order and sequence. So what is the sequence? It is a fundamental sequence. It is order and fundamental sequence. So what is that? Formation of gametes. After that, fission of gametes. It means it is known as a fertilization. Zygote. After that, embryogenesis. Okay, for the sake, for the convenient, so sexual reproduction is divided into that, okay, so three stages, three events. First one is the post fertilization. They are the three events. It is divided three events, three phases. Post fertilization events. Sorry, not post fertilization, pre fertilization events, sir. Pre fertilization events. Pre fertilization events. Second one is fertilization. Third one is post-fertilization. Right? Pre-fertilization events, fertilization events, after that post-fertilization events. So in this first one, this post, it means in the pre-fertilization events having mainly two steps. Pre-fertilization having mainly two steps. First one is the gametogenesis. Second one is gamete transfer. Gamete transfer. Okay. So we discuss about that pre-fertilization events. Pre-fertilization events. In pre-fertilization events, divide into two steps. First one is the gametogenesis. Second one is gamete transfer. In this first we discuss about that gametogenesis. Gametogenesis means formation of gametes. From gamete mother cell. So that is known as gametogenesis. Formation of gametes from gamete mother cell or organism. For example, some organisms produce similar type of gametes. They are known as homogametes. This is an objective bit. Example, cladophora. It is green algae. Okay, so remaining organisms, okay, for example, what are that? It means homogram of the green algae, for example, in the bryophyte and pteridophyte and gymnosperms and in angiosperms, okay, they are producing gametes different type. So they are known as that heterogametes. Heterogametes. So in that heterogametes, one is the small, another one is large. So they are known as that small is known as the male gamete, large is known as female gamete. Okay, they are known as that, okay, heterogametes, homogametes and heterogametes. So that is known as that gametogenesis, right? So after that, sexuality in organisms, in gametogenesis, another point is known as that sexuality in organisms. Sexuality in organisms. Generally, in the sexuality in organisms, so almost of all of the plants are showing of that, okay, unisexuality, and some are bisexual condition. For example, some plants shows bisexual condition. Bisexual condition, for example, fungi, also shows bisexual, bisexual. So that is a condition is known as that homothallism or bisexual, it is known as that monoecious condition. So bisexual, this condition is known as that monoecious, right? It is that homothallism. Example, some plants showing of that male flowers and female flowers, both are present on the same plant, male and female flowers present on same plant, present on same plant. So that is known as that, okay, homothallism. It means it, that is known as that so it is that monoecious bisexual condition. Okay, so what are that? Coconut, maize, castor seed, cucumber and watermelon. So generally, one plant having that both flowers, male and female flower, male and female flowers present on the same plant, that is known as the monoecious. Coconut, maize, okay, castor seed and cucumber and watermelon. So these are that monoecious. After that, so for example, some, okay, so plant showing of the dioecious. So dioecious plants means male flowers, female flowers formed on different plant. Formed on different plants, that is known as that dioecious condition. So in the dioecious condition, for example, so you observe that date palm, dates, Vallisneria, it is a hydrophytic plant, okay. Next, Carica papaya, papaya plant, okay. So these are the dioecious plants. It means it produce, okay, only one type of flowers, either male flowers or female flowers. So that is known as the dioecious or unisexual. It is known as that unisexual. If the fungi is showing shows both, it means the fungi shows unisexual thallus, that is known as heterothallism. Okay, so that is known as sexuality in plants. So in this, if plant produce male flowers, so they are known as staminate flower. It produce only stamens. It form only stamens. Only stamens. So that is known as a male flower. Female flower, so it is known as that pistillate flower. It produce flowers, it form having the only pistil. It has only that pistil. So that is known as sexuality in organisms, or sexuality in organisms or plants. Right? After that,